It's a pleasure to be here. But I'm from Missouri as well, like our host comedian today. So I'd like to say a few words just about myself. I do know that being a 56 model queer, my husband is also a 56 model queer who is raising a son, and we have four grandchildren, and we're expecting our to be great grandchildren. Read a few notes here. It was dismissed in the state of Missouri because of the fact that the Circuit Court of Appeals felt that in the Eastern Division, the judge did not have the right to make the decision. That's when Lambda Legal, who I had known for many years, contacted my attorney and brought me forward. You'll have to imagine that being an advocate of effort for AIDS is, you know, that first go around went through. I sort of felt that, you know, I dropped back into the life of being a married man legally, thanks for that. And after some almost 30 years. When Lambda contacted us and said, would you be willing to come forward? My husband is a 20-year retired Air Force Master Sergeant who has also put in, you know, 20 years with another company based in Washington, D.C. And it's good to know that he actually has made a decision to bypass the Secret Service clearance if it comes to that, to be a part of this movement now in 2018. So, basically, we're no strangers to change and adversity. But I just want to say also to my other two plaintiffs for coming forward, you know, the grace to be here. And I have to tell you, I served as the Vice President of Business Development for several of the largest staunch Republican white-collar companies in the United States for close to 25 years. And if you ask them about that gay guy from the Midwest, they would say, yeah, that homosexual that made us a whole bunch of money over the years. There was really no discrimination there. So another off-the-record personal thing I'd like to add. It's so important today, and I feel this from my heart, I've had 2 years now to actually let all this sink in. And I know Lambda Legal is prepared to take this all the way to the Supreme Court if we're not able to do something in District 8. And we have to win this, and we have to win this together. As most folks have said before me, none of us are going to do this alone. And I tried, after I fell short of getting this position that I had been offered, I tried to do it on my own. I tried to sort of fix it. And this is a much better opportunity for all of us to do it together. So thank you.